Bass slide rolling out with Lockhart. Moving fusion rolling out of myself to smoke a sonnet. G-Duck, also in room 2, we're bringing you the best in dubstep, electro, R&B and hip-hop, hosted by Star C, Accelerate, Bad Influence and Scarface. Remember the Credit Crunch £5 tickets are only available for a limited time, or it's £8 on the door. Also, you can get tickets from www.breakonergy.co.uk, Gatefield Sound, Soundhouse, Bird Eye, also Talk Nightclub. Alternatively, you can call 077-091-76-134. Standard procedures, it's all popping off. Saturday the 29th of May, where's it at? We're taking it back to Break Energy, mate. We're taking it back to Break Energy, mate. We're taking it back to Break Energy, mate.
Yo, yo, rough stuff. It's that time again, you know, blood. Yeah, Fool for June at SOS. What, we're going back to Kent on this one? What, the birthday party, yeah? Alright, cool. Yo, Massive, get ready. It's that time again. You know what it's all about. You know what it's all about, innit? Yo, swagger, 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 tastic. Birthday business, live in Tonbridge, yeah. Swagger, 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 tastic. Rough stuff, punk star, yes. Swagger, 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 tastic, birthday business, live in town, mid-rowing. Swagger, 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 tastic, fuck the rough stuff, yes, SOS. Yaga, yo, yes, Massive, UNCZ Promotions presents Swagger. DJ Rough Stuff and MC Funster's birthday bash, all taking place on the 4th of June at Source of Sound, 2 to 12, Amesbury Avenue, Tonbridge, Kent, TN9, 1TF. And believe me, we ain't holding back, no way! Artists on the night will be full uncontrollable showcase. DJ Rockstar, myself the Funster, Skibbity and the Harry Shotter, alongside the Groove Rider, Brian G, Hazard, Jumping Jack Frost, DJ Pleasure, Logan D, Magistrate, and the Mr. J Carter back to back with Uno. MCs on the night will be Funster, Skibbity, Harry Shotter, Dr. EPS, IC3, Shelba, Fearless, Foxy, Yardie, Spider, Mecca, Trickster back to back with Cody, Danger back to back with Melody, and the Spooker back to back with Toofy. Oh God! Attractions on this night will be 40K Function 1 sound system, intelligent lighting, a VIP area, and polite security. Also, make sure your swagger is intact. Free giveaways, the best dressed couple gets a bottle of champagne on the night. Trust me, it's real
swagger-tastic.
Tickets for this unmissable night will be limited £10 early bird tickets, then £12 plus booking fee. More on the door. Online tickets available from www.ravetickets.co.uk. Also available at all your usual outlets: Black Market London, RI Records, Gravesend, Gatefield Sound, Turn Bay, and Soundhouse, Broadstairs. It's a Kent thing. So all my London crew, Kent Massive, Worldwiders, this one definitely not to be missed. It's the Uncontrollable Promotions Rockstar Funster's birthday bash. Swagger! Swagger, 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 tastic birthday business, live in Tonbridge, mine.
See you there, 4th of June, SOS. Goes the champagne. Champagne.
You are now in tune to the sound of DJ Fully Equipped and DJ Hitman.
Yeah, this happens to be the shocking, bigging up the heavy artillery Massive in the hizzle. Hey, Diddle.
Right, mic check, 1, 2.
Yeah, yeah.
What's happening, 5-0? Welcome, right, brother.
Heavy artillery in the place, man. I mean, mass weapons of mass good destruction, you know?
Yeah, you know that, brother. We love to send the love and peace and the drums.
Yeah, man, always. Always love out here, you know what I'm saying? Always, you guys.
All right, cool, man. Just a few big ups and things. You're locked into the Heavy Artillery Show every Thursday from 9 to 11 on fatbeats.co.uk. Want to big up the sponsors, Cam, right? Big shout-outs going to Fat J, who makes this all happen. Out to all the studio managers. Out to everyone in the drum and bass industry that also makes this happen. And big up to the viewers, you know what I mean? This is what we do we do this for you. You know what I mean? So all the questions you ain't able to answer, like you, the person you follow, you know what I mean, and get educated. Like we've got Manman 5-0 here.
Good evening.
Whatever questions you have, get them over to us. You
above the belt, nothing below the belt, yeah?
Yeah, that's
keep
cool,
above
man.
The belt.
Like I said, yeah, above the belt, any questions you got, send them in and we get them straight over to him, man. So, right, let's go. You're locked into the Heavy Artillery Show with myself fully equipped. Hold tight, Hitman behind the decks. You cool, Hitman?
Yes, Hitman in the place.
Bless up. You cool, Five?
I'm good. I'm all good, man. I'm all love. I'm good. I'm well. Thanks. You know, thank you very much for inviting me to come and do this interview, you know, because it means a great deal to myself. You know, it's been a while since anyone's actually conducted an interview with myself. In a minute, you know. So it's good that you. It's nice of you guys to invite me to come and do this interview, which I'm happily obliged to do. So you know what I mean.
No,
so
man, we got enough respect for you, Fives. You know what I mean. Thank you for coming, Dan.
No,
you know what
honestly,
I mean?
Thank you for the opportunity for allowing me to be here with you guys. You know, as I said, it's your, you know, it's your setup, and you know, it gives me great honour to be here amongst you guys. You know, the fact that you guys are actually asking me to come and be part of your thing. You know what I'm saying? So it's a great honour for myself too. You know what I mean? Bless up for you guys for that as well. Big up. Honestly.
Thanks, Fives. That's respect. Cool, man. Enough respect towards you, brother. Right, yeah, so basically, as we do each and every Thursday, we're gonna we bring our special guest on, we put them for a 30-minute interview, and we give you, the viewers, a chance to interact and also learn a bit, you know what I mean, whether they're an up-and-coming DJ or MC or artist, you know what I mean, whatever they've got going on in the industry, you're about to find out now. And as I said earlier, we've got 5-0 in the building, so you know you're going to get a lot of education.
a lot of knowledge as well.
So, yeah, you know what I'm saying? A lot of knowledge, you know what I mean? A lot of education, and you're going to hear a lot of history going on right about now. So remember that you're locked into the Heavy Artillery Show every Thursday, 9 to 11, all right? The mic. All right, so get your questions down, and we'll get them straight out to 5-0, and we'll get them answered, all right? But like I said, we're just going to conduct the interview. We're going to start running that now, a little 30 minutes with you. And if
sure,
it's cool
man.
With you, Fred,
yeah,
we're
going
to ask
cool,
you to
man.
Jump up and show like the people what you're here for, man, and what you're here to do. Like
I'm about.
Yeah.
I'm great. I'm a lot more about just MCing as well, you know what I'm saying? So.
Well, us, we know that, you know what I mean? But there's certain viewers out there that like to follow drum and bass, and we're just trying to keep the history alive,
yeah, of
man.
Course, of course, most definitely. I mean, things need to be recorded, you know, in order for it to sustain itself. You know what I mean? I think, like, as you've seen in history, in any kind of facet of life, regardless of what it may be, it's always recorded, so it can always be passed on to generations for later on, you know, because, as I said, these are the things that's it's a great thing, like, with this jungle drum and bass thing, Acid House, you know, we can grow to a phenomenon, you know, which in my lifetime didn't ever think it would ever gone and surpass the things that I would have thought it could ever become.
What's that? Say that again, sorry, what do you mean? Like, you were saying from back in the day, from
yeah.
when you was up and coming and stuff like that,
yeah, like,
you couldn't see it going like this.
Yeah, it wasn't even so much up and coming because it was like, because people like myself and...
Well, it was brand new, wasn't it? It was fresh.
Yeah, it's fresh. Yeah, I'm saying it's brand new and straight out. I mean, nothing had hit the shores of this country ever. Nothing had come across in the UK of a magnitude such as like the Acid House. You know, the phenomenon of the Acid House, it was very remnants of days of like Woodstock in America.
Yeah,
it was like that's how it became. It was as a cult following when the Acid House came about because it was originally and derives from out of Ibiza. Not you know a great deal of probably a lot of listeners and viewers right now would probably not aware of that because a lot of it, this stuff thing starts from Ibiza from like from the house music and that and. The events that they was doing back in the day in Haiti, Ibiza, up to this day, as you know, Ibiza is the party capital of the world, so to speak, in terms of the best clubs in the world for doing events in.
Well, yeah, you got Space out there.
Yeah, Space, Es Paradis, which is called Man in Mission, like, what was it called back in the day? Coup Club, back in the day. And now we know.
That's where they had the live funny business
yeah,
going on,
isn't it? The funny, yeah, that's sort of funny stuff, yeah. Not for consumption right now, listeners.
What are you saying? What, no drum and bass dude's been done there yet?
No, you know, in actual fact, I'm not sure. I could, don't hold me to...
Well, actually, yeah. Saying that, you got some beats coming up, haven't they?
Yeah, I'm looking to go over there as well. I'm looking to go to some beats as well, so...
That'd be cool,
that'd
man.
Be, yeah, I'm quite looking forward to that. I think that will be a new dawn in jungle drum and bass in terms of, like, moving on to the Balearic Islands and really moving it out there now. And I think... from it, it takes off, and I wish, and I think it will take off, because you know I'd be recognised for house, right. and I could see it really having a very strong foothold, especially if the clubs are filled, people are having a good time, the people on the island, it's been spoken about and it's talking about, and yeah, and I could see it being something for the next coming, for the foreseeable future.
Yeah, that's cool, yeah. Man. So, right, let's gonna ask you some of the questions straight off of our programme we've written up for you, and as we do every guest.
Fire away, blah, blah, blah. Heavy artillery, innit? Bop, bop, bop!
It's gotta be done, man. So basically, if you just give us your honest opinion, 5-0, you know what I mean? And
I'm always honest and straight. That's one thing about me. I'm always honest and straight about when it comes to this scene here. You know, because I'm a baby, I love it. You know what I'm saying? So, there's nothing I'm gonna lie or deny about it. You know what I'm saying? I'll just talk my thing straight, and if it offends people, then hey, that's tough, isn't it?
Yeah, you know what I mean, it's a tough king.
All
right, so first question is like, can you tell us a bit about yourself? You know what I mean? Where did it all begin for you? Why YMCing? You know what I mean? All kind of stuff like that. You know what I mean? Can you tell us a bit about yourself? Why the name Firebo? Because like, what is it saying? Like, the police are in the building, yeah?
Yeah. Well, you know what it is. Yeah, you know what it is. In terms of when we'll start with what made me get into this. When I was younger, growing up, you know. Born and bred in England, black British kid, and you know, there's things like the, you know, sound system. When I was of my era, my following was the sound system thing.
What's that? Or like the, when you say sound system?
Sound system's like, you know, today you got Mighty Crown, I thought it started from the sound system for me in the UK, such as sounds such as like Unity, where Ragga Twins, now who they're called Ragga Twins, but they were, those days they were Flint and D-Man. And also Saxon Studio.
Saxon, I've heard a lot of things about Saxon. Yeah,
Saxon Studio and Flint and Demon Rockers in particular. Those guys, when it comes to like MCing and lyrical, you know, capabilities and some of the things that they was coming against, saying, because those
was
guys.
Was it when you say sound system as well, Fives? Was it jungle back then?
No, it wasn't jungle. It was all reggae sound.
Rare groove.
Yeah,
and
it was
all
like
that,
rare groove. You have reggae because back in those days, there, you know, growing up in the '80s and all that sort of stuff. There, like, you know, from the '80s coming up, you had either as a young, if you was young and black, there was either two sides of music. There was either like soul, you know, the soul boys, or you was like the reggae boys. Yeah, you know? I mean, that's how it was.
Yeah,
well,
like
days,
we say, mods and rockers.
Yeah,
and
yeah, a bit like mods and rockers and all that sort of stuff. So there was a kind of type of divide. He's like, you know, you dressed up suave, you got your winkle pickers on, so you was a soul boy. But if you was more like more of a ragamuffin kind of, you know, like today you'd be like, you know, it'd be like low bats and boots, so to speak.
What you say, have you got an eight ball jacket? Have you?
Yeah, I've got my eight ball jacket, but it's still somewhere there anyway. So that's how it was started out for me, because you know it was through things like Saxon Studio and. You know, like Tipper Irie, Philip Levi, Asher Sennett.
Who were they? Five, sorry, man.
These are MCs who was on this sound system run by Trevor Saxon, Musclehead, who were the DJ selectors, and Tipper Irie and Philip Levi and all that. Like, they were the MCs, and they'd be spitting the bars and the lyrics and all that. And like, I was so amazed by how they used to. You know, have the events up. We used to go all these parties used to follow, and these are British kids. You know what I'm saying? These are our very own British kids. You know, who I was like, man, I'd like to emulate those guys. You know what I'm saying? But they were a bit younger than myself. But at the same time, these guys were like a phenomenon, and they still are in their own rights. Yeah. So when it comes to spitting bars and seeing, that's where originally it comes from, the sound system. And as a matter of fact, as a point, I have to say. When it comes to MCing and lyricing, the first ever man to ever spit lyrics on a tune, yeah, was U-Roy. It ain't no American, because everybody gets the impression.
What you're saying? What? Any like?
When it comes to lyrical context, spitting. You
so
know,
this was before like.
We were talking back in the 1960s, 50s.
Before Slick Rick and all that.
Before all them guys. Remember, hip hop comes from is originally at Jamaica, because it was. People like Grandmaster Flash and Kool Herc, who was Jamaicans, who went to America, to New York, and they set up their turntable, like a one turntable, and they're just playing, and yeah, there's just a man just wasn't even rhyming, it was hip hop, and yeah, just a few little things, make some noise, and you know, yes.
Hosting more than, yeah?
Yeah, it was toasting. As a matter of fact, I'm glad you mentioned that, it was called toasting. It wasn't called
toasting,
MCing.
Yeah,
it's the original name is called toasting. It's not. you know, what people call today, like spitting rhymes, spitting bars, and you know what I mean? It's toasting. That's the original name of it. It's called toasting. And, you know, you got guys, I said, like, U-Roy, Big U, all these guys, like Lone Ranger.
And these were British, these were English.
No, these guys were Jamaicans. These are like the Jamaicans. That is why, you know, the Jamaicans in particular, that is why, I'll say it here right now, the Jamaicans, when it comes to MCing, rhyming, spitting, bars, whatever, they are the best in the world. They are the best. There's nobody better than them because they're the ones who created it. And they, you know, they're the ones who took it to America. And it was through in America, that's when you got the Melly Mells, the Grandmaster Flash, the EPMDs, the KRS-Ones,
Scott La Rocks,
the Public Enemies. So it all you know, so its roots and its heritage directly stems from Jamaica. And the same, very much the same thing for like those who was coming to the UK back in the days of the 50s and that, like, my mum and my dad's and all that, when they were coming here, you know, all the music was coming from Jamaica, you know, and that is the music that was in the community back in the, as I said, those days. Now when you look at hip-hop today, you know, as I said, 30 years ago, hip-hop was looked upon and frowned upon, like, oh, that's jungle bunny music, what kind of music is that? You know what I mean? And look at hip-hop now. Hip-hop is the biggest selling music format in the world now. It's pop. It's not even hip-hop no more. It's pop music now, you know. And
when you got Robbie Williams trying to rap over,
yeah, it's pop music now. So, you know, as I said, those are my inspiration when it comes to, like, MCing. But for me in particular, those guys in the UK, you know, there's Java Sound System, there's Coxon, you know, people like Tenafly, Top Cat, you know, all these guys that, you know, have been my kind of British UK influence. That they made me want to go on the microphone. And the opportunity kind of came around to me when the birth of Acid House in 1988. And at the time there wasn't any real MCs. If we're going to go through the history, the first actual man I actually saw MC rhyming is a guy called Daddy Chester. He was doing with a DJ, but he was a producer at the time named Adamski. That was 19.
What was he making?
They were making electro house, what they call electro house, but it was house, but more electronic kind of music sort of stuff.
Okay.
So Daddy Chester was
but the like the like the house that Jack built. No, remember that tune?
Yeah. I mean, tunes such as that, and even before that, yeah, tunes such as that house that Jack built. Yeah, those type of tunes at the day. And I can't remember a lot of the artists, but a lot of those kind of acid house tunes from way back. And Adamski was one of the first major producers in the scene, so to speak. And that's how the growth. He was the first MC I actually saw, and then there was Chalky White. There's Man Paris. He's from up Birmingham. MC Majika.
Majika.
He was also doing things with like Carl Cox. You know, and when we talk about early MCs, you know, then you talk about Mad P from out of Top Buzz. You know, and then you got GQ, myself, Moose. You know, as
singing
like
facts.
Yeah, you got singing facts. But we were like the foundation, so to speak, because those days, we was doing my first ever break was Crazy Club, going to Carl Pearson. If you locked in Carl Pearson, and I went in a Crazy Club.
Where was Crazy Club?
I was at Astoria.
Was it called that before Astoria?
Yeah, no, it was Astoria, but the promotions was called Crazy Club.
Oh, okay, the night. Yeah.
Yeah, the night was called Crazy Club, and I'll never forget my first ever.
And that was Jungle, yeah?
No, that was Acid House. That was all Acid House. But as I said,
so you used to spit to Acid House?
Yeah, that's what we was doing. That's what we grew up to. We spit into that. Yeah, because as I said, remember, I come from the era of Sound System. So yeah. Coming from the era of Sound System, what you'll find is that a lot of the MCs who've ever been on a Sound System or been around like reggae music, heavily influenced, should have the ability and the capability to really spit on any type of music.
Yeah.
If you listen to like people like Elephant Man or Capleton or Beanie Man, these guys, they can spit on anything you put in front of them.
Well, as an MC, you know what I mean, as a lyricist, artist, kind of, that's your talent, you know what I mean? You should be able to, because we had MC Dreps from Uncontrollables up and coming on here last week, and that's what he was saying. You know what I mean? So he said, even if it was opera, I would try and spit on it.
Exactly. You know what I mean? Dreps is right, because as I said, you know, even like when I do, I might be doing an event and you never know what the DJ may play. I don't actually know what DJ is going to play. He can throw anything on the decks, and from that beat is there, And then, you know, that beat starts kicking, and then I'll just find the rhyme.
You vibe off that, yeah?
Yeah, just vibe off. It's just a, you know, just a spiritual thing, isn't it? It's just like, you know, something within you that just touches you and just moves you. But as I said, forward to what I was saying about the my first ever touchdown on the microphone, I was at Crazy Club in 1989.
Right, the year after I was born.
I mean, about 1989. And it was a Crazy Club, and Kenny Ken was playing.
What, when he, what was Kenny Ken DJing then?
Myself, me and Kenny Ken, we come up, me and Kenny Ken known each other before the scene even was created, from school days, from childhood. So me and Kenny Ken come up from childhood days, our people like DJ Ron and GQ. So we come up from a long time before the scene was even created. People like DJ Spoonie. Gary Spoonie.
Yeah,
Dream Team. Yeah, man, Gary Spoonie. Yeah, man, we went to school together, grew up together. Man like Spoonie, I could phone anytime. Them kind of man, I could phone them anytime. Well, go on Spoonie. What's up? What's Spoonie? He's like, yeah, what's up, Fives? Yeah. Spoonie's a good friend of mine. People like Trevor Nelson.
Oh, that's
cool.
We all
come from the same manner and all that type of thing there.
It's funny, all you boys, like you said, you know what I mean? You've all grown up together and then all gone, like, you know what I mean? Obviously, like you're saying, Acid House was the point there.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? You bred from that and then went into different kind of.
Well, you see what it is, right, man, is like this, yeah? Imagine, here's an analogy. Imagine you've got BMW. BMW is the company, yeah?
Yeah.
In BMW, you've got a 5 Series, a 3 Series, a Z3, a Z5, an M3, but it's all under the same banner of BMW.
It's just
different models, isn't it? But they still carry the BMW badge, isn't it? And it's just a different model. That's what it is. That's what the scene is. So from the Acid House, which is the umbrella, you might have Garage, Jungle, Drum and Bass, Acid House, Electro House.
Yeah, it's all gone mad now,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, so it all stems from that.
Oh,
so anybody who wants to say anything different, you can text up or they can email. If you don't happy what I'm saying, then if you want to challenge it, you're quite welcome to challenge it. I'm up for a challenge. So if you want to question it, you're quite happy to challenge it. But at the same time, what I'm saying is, like, that's what it stemmed from. And that's it. And that whole thing just grew. But as I said, from my experience when it comes to the MC, and as I said, when me and Kenny Ken was at Astoria, and then I said to Kenny, where's the microphone? Kenny goes to me. This time I'm nice, you know. Them times, remember, it's 1989, yeah? Somebody's bubbling, and everybody's, what? You know, things is going on. I'm not going to disclose, but use your imagination. But yeah, the whole thing was going on, yeah? When things was clean. Yeah, the whole stuff was clean in there, yeah? Proper clean.
You only needed one.
Not even one, I'll take half, I'll take quarter, thing. Boom, you're neat. You know? Yeah, man, you're neat. Quarter thing, you're nice. Right? So honestly, so them times, I'm bubbling, and we're nice, and but it was just. Kind of miss the music was excellent. The music was getting played was excellent. Tricky disco, certain tunes was getting played. Music was excellent, but it was just missing a spark. It was just missing something. So, being as the type person I am, I was like, you know what, Chuck? Because you know, cause I like to MC and rhyme and just do my thing. But as I said, I wouldn't put myself up against the guys I was speaking about earlier. We'll come to that as well. As I said, Kenny, where's the mic? So he goes, he's there. So I asked the engineer, and the engineer said to me at the store at the time, he goes, it's down there, which was the stage. And at this time, Crazy Club is jam. Ram block, traffic blocking, jam. Yeah? So I've had to make my way to the stage. Met the engineer. He's giving me the mic. It's cordless at the time. And I can remember so distinctly that when I... the mic was on, I said a few words, and then I was behind the curtain, I was kind of shy, so to speak. You see, when I stepped from beyond that curtain with the mic in my hand and I said a few words.
Well, you say, hang on, right, and you had lyrics before this now, yeah?
Well, they had lyrics, but at the time, it wasn't ready for lyrics. It was more...
What, for the Acid House? Like, for the Acid House, Kenny Ken was playing?
Yeah, at the time, it wasn't a time for lyricing thing, you know. I mean, you say a few words, you know, like myself and music, you say a few words and a few
toasting
things.
Yeah,
toasting and toasting and hosting, so to speak. It wasn't like what you get today. Yeah, it was more toasting and hosting at the time. And when I made my way from behind the curtain, I tell you what, the volume and the crescendo of noise that I received and the plaudits that came with it as well, because this is a story, and it's, you're talking about a magnificent theatre where many stars and celebrities have performed and graced that stage. Even that very same microphone I was probably holding and all. And for me to be to receive that adulation from, and the gratitude from all of the people in the audience, I just was levitating. I felt like the Messiah.
Well, he's on fire.
Yeah, man, I felt like the Messiah, bro. I was levitating. I swear to God, lads. It's like you could just, I was levitating through the whole place, man. And you know, when I had finished, that was like the birth of 5-0, so to speak. And the name, and he's asking about the name 5-0.
Yeah, where did 5-0 come from?
When I was in America visiting family quite a bit, and because what a lot of people don't understand is that when I kept going to America, there's a lot of things that we I'm not going to start saying we bought this, we bought it. There's a lot of things that we bought to England, like, you know, the name. The thing called this. I was one of the first persons to use that language. What you think of this? Imagine, what are you talking about? What's that? And when I was saying that, what means disrespect. So when I first brought that type of language up, people was like, well, get, what's that this thing? So when man said, oh yeah, who you think of this? That, you know, I remember bringing that coming over with me from 19. As I said, I went to my first ever visit to America was 1992. Yeah, I'm saying about 94 was when we tried to jungle, but. The first time I ever heard the word "this" was from my brothers.
We sat in street slang.
Slang in New York, because my brothers, they lived in Pacific Street, Atlantic Avenue, Flatbush, in the BK, Brooklyn, they call it, the tri-state. So that's when I first heard it. When I came to England, and I was like, okay. So when I was using it, it never happened. And I'll be like with like friends, not like my brother, but with some friends. We'd be driving around. My man would see me, man. That's the 5-0, man. And I think, what do you mean he's the 5-0? No, that's the feds, man. I was like, okay, so that was then. So when I actually came back, when I came back in the UK, I was like with some friends, we were driving around, you know, going, and I would say the same thing. I was saying, man, it's 5-0. And the man said, why do you keep saying that? And I just said it again. He's like, man, you know something, you're fucking, he said, excuse me, he's like, you're like them, you know, as a matter of fact, you're just like them, like in the parties. It's coming, like when you're in the parties, it's like when you people are out of order, it's like you just kind of you stop the party and you make this big public service announcement, and it's like you're almost like them.
You do that.
So I was like, right. So he goes, yeah, you know, as a matter of fact, your name's 5-0, yeah, and you know, and the name just stuck, and that was it. And people kind of viewed me and saw me as a law in the party, so to speak. I didn't go out my way to say, boy, this, I am the law. I didn't. There, it wasn't nothing like, yeah, there's a new sheriff. He's a new sheriff in town. It wasn't like that. There's a new sheriff in town here, and it wasn't nothing like that. So it's, you know, the people I felt like the people and the general public kind of made me feel like I was a lawmaker, so to speak. You know, and I was just saying things. I'm not dictating anything to anybody or telling how people should be or they should actually, but. I'm like this, when I'm in an event, my first thing is safety for everybody. Safety is of paramount, you know, because I wouldn't want to know I'm doing my thing on my watch that something terrible happened to somebody I was entertaining, man. You know what I'm saying? I take those things to heart personally if they was on my watch. So like an incident, someone got robbed, someone changed, got pulled, someone got stabbed, someone got whatever it may be. Those things there, I'll get really teed off with things like that, because it's the last bastion and the last social place where we can all gather and, you know, let off a bit of steam. And
well, saying that, like, now you've brought that up, right? Right, as you say, you know what I mean? You come through, you see a lot of it, right? So you're saying from Acid House days, you know what I mean, to the jungle when it first come through and all that, like, how you're saying the chain snatching thing, you know what I mean? You wouldn't like to see that done.
No.
Do you think nowadays it's a complete joke to what it was? Like the whole vibes and like, you know what I mean?
You know what, seeing the days, right, with events such as like, okay, we're talking it straight. See that roast, yeah?
What's that, Sunday roast?
Sunday
yeah?
Roast, yeah. Roast, yeah.
That's Kingsley.
Kingsley and Everton, Edmund. Yeah, and Paul Roast, the original promoters and all that, yeah. See roast, yeah? And I'm on fatbeats.net, yeah? Let me show you something, yeah? This ain't no bigging up, no bad man ting or anything like that, yeah. But hear what they see. Rose. Rose is the original OG dance, yeah. Where all the original G's gangsters then from all around the country used to come to Rose. And they, and you know what used to give me great, great vibe and great spirit between me and Moose is that, imagine, we have all these heads in here. Yeah? And some of these people are capable of going on with some ugly behavior. Yeah, believe me, but the one thing what we all shared was that this, that, you know, you had like Ryder, Ron, Kenny, Frost, you know, and they're playing the music, providing the music, and then you got myself and Moose there, who are there hosting and comparing and emceeing. It only takes one, it only takes someone just to just fly off the handle and say, boy, ooh, I don't even like 5-0 Moose, and just kick off. But we never had that. And that was a great testament to us because we used to always keep it in order. If there wasn't an altercation, I'd be the first one off the stage with my mic, boom, straight in the middle. Yo, we're not having that. We're not having it. As a matter of fact, chop, drink some champagne, yeah? Easy. Have that. You know what I mean? Do your thing, yeah? Have a thing, yeah? Just cool, yeah? And the party was just rolled. And like, roast wasn't the type of event for the faint-hearted. It was like, it was a people of sheer, pure confidence. As I said, the music, as we said earlier, how this Acid House business got created was out of the fact that it was reject music. It was for the rejects. You know, we, people such as myself and people, you know, people from the council of states, as I was saying earlier, but when we was at my home, people from the council of states was going to, you know, affluent clubs in the West End back in the 80s, and they were saying, not tonight, mate, you need a girl, you need shoes, you need a tie. Everyone was getting knocked back.
What are you saying? So, like, as you say, like, people like underprivileged kids, you know what I mean, to the middle classes, you was actually getting turned away from clubs.
We was getting turned away from the clubs back in those days in the 80s, you know, getting knockbacks, you know, not just myself, but youngsters from all across London who was going through that. And this is the reason why the birth of Acid House come about, and this is where we had the growth of stations like Rush FM and Dance FM and Cool FM, and you know, this is where we felt like, you know, this is something that needed to be tapped into, and like we could grow from this with something which is sheer and pure independent of the people, for the people, by the people, and that is why it sustained this. It's time where we are today, you know. And as I said, my first thing is safety is of the most paramount importance for me when I'm doing an event, that I want to make sure that everyone's safety is a paramount when I'm in there. When I'm in there, I ain't just a spitting bars. I'm also observing what's going on. If I can feel or even see potential.
Well, you would be, though. You know what I mean? That's your baby there.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's jungle, like, you bring it to us. So to get a load of people in there taking the mic, you'd be like that, wouldn't you?
Of course, because I'm a type of guy like this, as you said with the name 5-0, I like to consider myself like Lord of the Land, because like, if there's anybody getting out of order, that thing, why would you want to endanger other people's lives in the place? Why would you want to spoil everybody else's fun? If you got an issue, take your issue outside. I say many a time when I'm doing an event, if anyone's got any discrepancies, or you know, you've got any issues or discrepancies with a fellow man or woman in there, either you deal with your issue here and now and get it outside, or if it goes off, you're both going. Whoever it is, you're going. We don't care. I've done it many occasions.
Like, when we had Eastman here as well, right? And basically what he was saying, you know what I mean? From how it is today and all that, obviously because of the law and all that, you have to take it easy on troublemakers and all that. But he was saying back in the day, you couldn't mess around.
Listen,
like that,
you see, back in the day, yeah? Even before the Acid House scene was come about. And we could talk about security as well. There used to be a security personnel from London, yeah, called Rat Security. And they used to do like the reggae events back in the day and all that. And
what's that? Rat, R-A-T?
R-A-T, yeah, Rough and Tough. That's what it was called.
That was called, yeah.
Yeah, Rough and Tough. Rat. And these guys and this security person team, they never used to mess about. Honestly, they
strong presence, yeah?
Very, very strong presence. And they made their presence felt. Maybe with a bit more, with more training and more professional training in how to have public relations and deal with public order.
Well, that's what you need.
If they had that, they would have been like nothing less than a SAS team. Nothing less than a SAS team, honestly, SAS team. I swear, because they was just militant, precise. If someone was out of order, believe me, that person would be straight away out. Whoever causing the grievers or the disturbance will be removed straight. And these guys would not mess about removing you fast. And if you saw that, he was like, first thing he comes to, he's like, boy, don't want happening to me. And that sets the tone already. So,
because like, yeah, I know what you're saying there as well, speaking about security, you know what I mean? My mum's fella is like, he's a warrior. And he done all the security for like Desert Storm.
Yeah, okay, well, that's the rest of his thing. Yeah, yeah. I know Warrior, man. What do you mean? Warrior, big up Warrior. What?
Like, you know from there.
Come on, man. It's Warrior, big up Warrior, man. That man, they can tell you a great deal. He's a man you need to get on this side of the fence as well. Warrior. Yeah, man. Big up Warrior. Enough respect to Warrior, definitely. Big up to that guy.
Yeah, because you know, I mean, like, he tells me stories like.
He can tell you some fantastic story, Warrior. He's a security. He's seen a lot.
You've seen how big he is as well,
mate. Warrior has seen a great deal in this scene here. You know what I mean? And there are some security personnel. As I said, I've got a good affiliation with all security personnel. I've never had to have a
run. Do you think that's good, yeah? As a member, like, as someone who's actually live and in the events and all that, and for promoters and stuff like that, it's good to have that relationship with
security, of course. I can't speak for anybody else, but I speak for me. And there's any security personnel out there in the time I've been doing what I've been doing for the last 20 odd years, yeah, no security personnel in particular can say that I've ever been obnoxious, I've ever been rude, I've ever been profound to them. I've always been polite to them. Every time I come to an event, I always greet them, shake their hands. If I know them personally, I'll give them a hug, you know, just show them love. And I shake the hands of every person, every staff, as I walk in, security personnel, until the time I walk out.
Because they're not, like, I don't know how we got in this, like, conversation about security, you know what I mean? But as a young man, like, anyone in that suit, you know what I mean? I used to, like, go, whoa, you know what I mean? You ain't telling me what to do. But you got to remember, at the end of the day, if there's a girl who's fallen over from taking, like, say, a bad drug they're the ones who are there making sure she's got the space around her that she needs for first aiders to get through. So, saying that, we have got to give it to security, and we maybe shouldn't give them such a hard time. Yeah, they're only doing their job. Yeah,
doing their job, but then there's also this as well. There's always, you know, people always use that phrase, just doing my job, but. There's doing your job and there's doing your job. It's how you go about doing your job.
Yeah.
And that's my issue.
Because you know you get the certain brothers and you're like, oh, I'll be back with my gun.
Yeah. that's a lot of, that's just an ear talk. And then there are some of them who are capable of carrying out that type of act. As I said, you know, I know of gunmen and that type of thing there. And for the most of them, it's a phase and it's a fad and it lasts for a period of time. You can't always be a gunman into your 50s and into your 60s. That stuff will end up catching up at some point. No one stays a youth. No one's immortal. Nobody is immortal. And my motto is this: a man is measured by his deeds, but not what he's got and what he's done. You're measured by your deeds. That's the only way you get to the pearly gates, yo.
Big up on that, Fives.
You know what I mean, King?
Right, just a couple of shout-outs. All right, hold tight to Nigel Mancott. He's saying, any old Mr. Vegas...
Any old Mr. what?
Any old Mr. Vegas. Probably can hear the 7 inches in the background.
Okay.
Big shout out to DJ Ease. Hold tight. Beppe. A few of the crew. Let's just get some of these read out. Sorry for it.
Cool, man. Read them out, man. I love to read.
TBO. Got Wizzo. This is boys. Big up. Sounding live inside. Big up on that. Hold tight. Calms. Then hold tight. The Karma. The Live and Fatty. Loving the interview. Hold tight, Nigel Manker again on that one, saying thank you. Hold tight, Crims. Right, a few more. Hold tight, Fung, saying bloody hell.
Now females, where's my junglets? Where's my fiverets and my fiverlets? Where you at, man? Come on, girls.
Hold tight, Nigel Manker. Big up on that one, brother. Just got that message. Hold tight, dude, saying location London. Hold tight, Shawnee G and Dave Smith. Hold tight, George. Saying he's coming from Mars.
I'm
sure. That's him acid hearse days, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Hold tight, DJ Dizzy. Yeah, man. Thank you for locking in, guys. Hold tight, the viewers. Remember, if you've got any questions for Firebo,
hit me up, man. Send them through,
and they'll answer it. But make sure you remember you're listening to the Heavy Artillery Show with myself, DJ Fully Equipped, and DJ Hitman. We do this every Thursday, 9 to 11. A couple more big ups. Remember, you got Swag. Swagtastic coming soon. That's Rough Stuff and Fun's birthday bash at the SOS Club in Tunbridge Wells. And we've got Breakology coming soon. We've got a few raves we're going to promote and stuff later out there for the masses. Also, we've got a few competitions going on soon, so make sure you stay locked in for that and you'll win yourself some vintage merchandise and also some guest lists for future raves coming up. And once again, thank you, Hitman, for reminding me. We are legend. Down tonight, is it Shoreditch, Brick Lane?
No, it's Commercial Street.
Commercial Street, sorry.
Gramophone,
yeah, that's it. So if you're about in London tonight, get yourself down to Gramophone. I think it's mere £3 on the door, isn't it?
And there's, I've no idea.
You've got Nino Micro down there, DJ Viper. There's a few DVSD.
It'd be a good look.
So you'll see us down there later, but if you're about in London, in East London, Commercial Street, get yourself down to there, all right? But I hope you're enjoying the show. Remember, bad feedback, good feedback, it's all feedback.
Yeah,
Send it through.
That's right.
Help us improve or let us know if we're doing all right. All right, but we're just going to carry on with some more questions.
Of course.
Cool phone.
Yeah, man. Some more questions, yo.
And we're going to jump up on the ones and fours and get you on the mic.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so... So, roughly, go on, straight answer, how long have you been an MC for?
Officially since
1989. Do I have to do the math?
Well, I ain't doing it.
Well, if I'm 22 and I was born in 88, add on another year or take it away, that's like, what, 21 years?
Yeah, when I was doing it, but officially, like, in events, you know, it was things like, as I said, 89.
Yeah, that's a good question. What was your first ever event? Because I remember you was talking about Crazy...
Crazy Club, Astoria. Yeah. That was my my debut, so to speak, when I stepped out in the front of the stage. That was my debut. I got to say, big up Chalky White as well, MC, original MC Chalky White. Enough love, big up them man, them. That was my first official kind of.
Alright, let's put about first jungle.
First official jungle was Termills Rose. Yeah, Termills Rose. That would gave me my first official.
You want to explain how that happened? How'd you come up to that one? Was that through, like, obviously being known on the scene before jungle kicked off?
Yeah, because when we was doing the. I said Back to the Future, we remember those events like Back to the Future, Genesis, Biology, Energy, Raindance,
yeah?
Yeah. And all these magnificent events. Amnesia House, which was up north, which is Mickey Linus, and like Carl Cox and them guys used to play with Lenny D, Robbie D.
And Carl Cox, like house DJ?
Yeah, well, Carl Cox, we all started that together. All of us have all started that together doing that thing here. You know, Carl Cox is massive. And Rose was a really the kind of.
Well, they've started bringing things back now, haven't they, Rose?
Yeah, well, they're doing one-off events and things like that. You know, they're just doing them catered around seasonal, which I think is a good thing because, you know, when they did the first one, that was good, but when they did the other one, Scarlet, that was a fantastic look. That was like.
What, Rose at Scarlet, yeah?
Yeah, man, that was like, wow. That was like, boy, that was like, yeah, Astoria, Linford Studios. And also, like, when we did Jungle Fever as well the other day at Club Fire, when we had in our room, I thought the room we was in was an excellent room. I enjoyed it so much. That reminded me of days of, you know, like Coventry Edge, Curtain Road. We first did Curtain Road, Coventry Roller Express, Stevenage Ice
Roller
Bars.
Express.
We had some good events in the Desert Storm.
That was around the corner, innit, really?
And saying that, I just wanted to say to the listeners as well, as a matter of fact, Desert Storm, yeah, get it to Jarvis Sandy and get it to Willie. Yeah, Willie, VIP Champagne Bash, which happens to be Mr. Jerk, down at when Nicky Black Market's got his record shop. That's his food shop there, Mr. Jerk. So, VIP Willie. So, Willie, anyway, yeah, there, my brother, big up. See that guy there, yeah? Willie and Jarvis, Sandy, yeah, I have to say this. Those guys had an event, yeah, Desert Storm, yeah. I'll never forget, it was on New Year's, I think it was. And myself, Flinty, D-Man, Navigator, Moose, was all on stage, Ron, I think Ron was playing, right, it was all there anyway. And I have never in my lifetime, yeah, never witnessed the size of the bottle of our antidote, which I call champagne, yeah, by the way, which is AKA, yeah?
Antidote, yeah.
Never seen a size of a... Listen, this champagne bottle was brought in by a forklift.
Shut up.
Yeah? Never in my, I've never witnessed it in my life.
Is that?
Not even,
soul,
listen,
yeah?
Not even F1 drivers have got the size. Listen, not even, I've never seen Lewis, Fernando Alonso, Michael Schumacher, none of them guys, them bust a bottle of champagne like this one here. Never in my life. This, as I said, they brought it in on a forklift.
Into the race,
it was
yeah?
a crate, a proper oh. crate. We had to open it with a crowbar. I kid you not. Listen, we had to open it myself. We was on a crowbar. We had to open this thing with a crowbar. And I swear to God, when we got it out, and it was a raffle. Believe it or not, it was a raffle. Some of the, it,
well, you could win this now.
This,
yeah?
this was the prize draw. People thought, oh, a bottle of champagne. Ah, I'm not making a bottle of champagne. But yo, this bottle of champagne, yo, I kid you not. Bro, it's about 5 foot. This bottle of champagne, I swear to God.
You got any pictures of that?
There must be pictures online somewhere. I don't know, because I could not believe it. And we're there, you know, we're on the stage, we're trying to open this bottle. You know, like you open a bottle like that. Joking. We're like this. We're both hands around, all of us like that, trying to open it. And when this thing pops up, it's like, oh my God, because it was a raffle draw, and it was a prize to be won. But because people thought, I was only ever telling you a raffle, it's only a bottle of champagne. No one decided they was going to buy the tickets. Not realizing, people just realizing it's a bottle of champagne, but not realizing what size of the bottle of champagne was going to be.
That's sick, man.
Yeah, it was sick. On the, as I said, it has to be the biggest bottle of champagne I've ever opened in my life. And I said, I swear to God, it was bought up by a forklift. So anybody who was at that event, at that night there, Roller Express, Desert Storm, whew, what a night that night was. Man, we got tanked up proper, the whole place. It was good. It was enough to go around. It was enough to go around.
Do you know what? That's love, you know. Like, yeah, man. Give that away in a raffle.
Yeah, man. That's proper love. You know what I'm saying?
You don't get that.
Fully equipped. No, you see what I'm saying? Because that recessional times and cutbacks and, do you know what I mean? Bankers are robbing us.
Do you know
us.
How much it is for a drink in certain clubs now?
I know. But that's another thing as well. Why, you know, where I think why you're finding in every genre of music, no matter who's, whatever music, it could be reggae, it could be garage, it could be hip-hop, it could be R&B, it could be drum and bass. Everyone's feeling a pinch because it's like the prices of the alcohol is they're pricing the people out. Like, it's like you can't. What's the point?
Like there's a recession on. No one's got no money. Let's throw the price on drinks up.
But this is another thing as well. Fully equipped that where the back in my days, I said we had a lot of the drinking culture now, going to the pubs and all that sort of stuff. You know,
I was talking to a load of boys at work, right, and they said that they used to go to the pub from 10 o'clock in the morning. It's shut at 2. Then you'd go and have your roast or whatever you was having. Yeah, yeah. Then you'd come back.
Come out, yeah.
Those if you made it,
yeah.
That was.
I've never been a drinker as such, but when I used to get with my pals and they used to be just like putting them away and, you know.
Yeah, they said the license from like 10 till 10 just ruined the whole flipping drinking.
It did ruin people socialising. Yeah, it did.
Your friends would come in, but then you'd be going.
Yeah, it did ruin. I think it did. Those kind of laws kind of did ruin things because it's like you could just drink at any given time now, and it was open for abuse now. You know what I'm saying? And I personally think, like, you know, because things are going to move on and things could never be the same and things are never going to stay in this time. But I think when the licensing laws, when they did things like that, because at the time, you know, as I said, it was based around family. Like, the husband would be with his own wife, da 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 da. And then when the pub's open, he's down the pub with his pals, snooker, smoking, while the wife's at home doing her thing. When he comes up, he's had a drink with his pals. So that's his night out. So he gave you time to socialise and all that. And with those things, laws come where you can come in at any time to drink. Now, there was no designated time where back in my time growing up, you had a designated time. You knew that, like, you finished work, after work, get yourself dolled up and all that. Bam, you're just down the road. Yeah, by 9 o'clock, boom, you're banging the pubs. I'm from Hackney, so in those days you had the Hackney Cab and from Hackney Road.
The Hackney Cab, what's that?
That's a pub. That's a famous pub. Pubs like Brian Beggar. All these sort of pubs from around Whitechapel and Hackney Road and Columbia Road, Bethnal Green, Roman Road. You know, these are all the places that used to frequent as a youngster and all throughout Hackney and all that. When I was getting my pubs, they was on the drinking team. I wasn't really a drinker. I was like, my name was there all the time, you know what I mean? You know, I'm in a green card. Yeah, so I was more a green card man still, you know what I mean? I wasn't really into the alcohol thing, so. And that's how it extends. And then when you talk about recessional times, I think the influx, when we was going through that recessional times and hard times, and what was happening, you know, where kids, youngsters were getting turned away from pubs and clubs and whatever, that was the growth of acid house, because they was finding that, they was thinking, well,
it's like you said earlier, like what you're saying about acid house and all that jungle is for rejects, like.
It was. That's the acid house. Acid house was created for rejects. Don't get me wrong. I mean, you had your middle class youngsters, people like Jeremy Taylor, Tony Carlson Hayter. You know, they come from very affluent families. You know what I'm saying? And they're very connected. But they were, you know, they were just like regular, like just you and I. You never think
genuine
were,
people.
Yeah, you would never think there was a tough. You wouldn't think there was like David Cameron or Nick Clegg. Do you know what I mean? They might have been a tough, but they was like straight. You know what I mean? You know, you could go around their house, they come around yours, they'd be around your company, they'd be in your area, they'll invite you to come to their area, and there was never snobbery that way there. You know, they're up there, but they had class. Basically, they had class. And forevermore, these people are still my friends, like Tarquin, Itzy. You know, these girls are, and guys, you know, they're very connected to affluent people. You know what I mean? Connected to your parts of royalty and all that. So I take that after enough respect to them because, as I said, they never tried to portray themselves as better than anybody else. You know, I'm a big up Tarquin for doing Weekend Well.
Yeah, you know, because these were promoters.
They're promoters. Remember, back in those days when we're raving and we're partying on private land, proper landowners. These people know the landowner, the person who owns the land. Remember, we're partying in an open field.
That's untouchable, isn't it?
We are partying in an open field. You know what I mean? You don't even know. You're just driving. And those are the fantastic days. You know what I mean? You know, and I was saying, like, fully equipped, those days we used to have things called mystery tours. Yeah? Where you just get a flyer, there'd just be a phone number on it. You don't even know where you're going.
Oh, I like the squat party.
Yeah, you don't know where you're going. You know, it's the meeting point, something might be King's Cross, some would be M25, South Mim Station. You know, and always was
a
base,
tours, yeah,
called Mystery Tours. It's always based around the M25, and someone will get the call and says, right, that person's got the call. They're like, right, this is where it is. But no one had, back in those days, I said in the early 80s, no one had one of these. Yeah, and if you did, you had one of them big power pack things. You know what I mean? You know, one of them big brick power pack stuff. You know what I'm saying? If somebody had one of those, like, you know, like a respirator machine or something like that, blood. So as soon as someone actually got the thing, then he had a pilot. And the pilot, you get to follow that pilot. You just see hundreds and thousands of cars just going down the M25.
Oh, I bet that was Pucker.
Oh,
man.
Mate, I'll tell you something.
You think they should do a mystery tour?
Yeah, they should. I think any promoter out there who's contemplating of putting on an event on a mystery tour, undisclosed venue anywhere in the country, I'm prepared to come there and perform there if you wish to do so. And it could work. It would work. It would definitely work. You definitely keep out undesirables.
Because the way I've heard it, like a few people have explained it to me, is that, like you said, you got your flyer with your number, but then you'd have to listen into the radio station clues.
For clues, that's right. You'd be listening. And this
that's
what was
genius, like, man. But for a load of beards.
It's like Krypton Factor. You know what I mean? Which is good, though. It's good. It's like Krypton Factor because the kids today, they don't want to think. They've got people thinking for them. So it was good for us to.
What are you saying? Everyone's buzzing off acid.
Yeah, people just doing their thing. And people's like, you know, be sitting
working.
And waiting. And people be phoning. But people's getting their stuff together. Where are you? The buzz and, you know, the vibe. You know what I mean? Not like today's like, oh, we going up. Oh, okay, down the road. Today. We playing? Oh, I'm playing down the road. It wasn't like that. You know what I mean? He's like, boy, we don't even know where we're going. Boy, we don't even know. Where are we going? Why we don't even know? Where is it? Oh, we heard it's Reigate. Oh, no. I heard it's in East Sussex. No, I heard it's in Brighton. No, I heard it's up. You don't know. I heard it's in Ipswich. I heard it's in Norwich. You don't know where you're going to be. And that was the great buzz of that because you never knew Journey into the Unknown. And as soon as you got
the you meet people along the way.
Yeah,
you meet
people along the way because, you know, you meet at a service station or you meet at King's Cross or you meet at a certain meeting points and you always had a pilot at each location, there'll be a pilot who actually knows. So they ring the phone, the pilot gets it, he's gone. Since he's in his car, boom, the pilot's like, you better follow the pilot. Straight. Yeah, you're a passenger, you gotta follow the pilot. So you had pilots at each destination and just cars.
So it was proper.
Proper organized, mate. Organized. Oh, I'll tell you, fully equipped hit, man, I'm telling you, I've never seen organizational skills like that on the magnitude of that without telephones, so to speak, because they weren't at the phone at the time.
Yeah, that's proper, man.
Yeah, that's proper organisation, mate. You know what I mean? That is like, you know, you could use that same strategy in war. You know what I mean? It's proper strategic how they went about doing it. And you know what? They completed it. They completed the task. And, you know, because as I said, I was going to events and 20,000 people.
Yeah, my uncles would tell me, like, they'd be coming
15,000 people.
You'd see Ferris wheels.
Yeah, man, Ferris wheels. You see the lasers going out.
I think Rain Dance did a few.
Yeah, Rain Dance did quite a number of them. As I said, Weekend Well, Karma Sutra. There were some big, massive parties back in the day. I can't remember all of them. Castle Duddington, you know, Fantasia, you know, these all those fantastic
events.
Dreamscape. Yeah, man, all these fantastic, great events from way back in there. And they're the ones who are responsible for what's going on today. And people should pay them homage and tribute to all these promoters, the promotions, all the MCs and DJs who worked tirelessly. People like Everson, Rat Pack, Lip Master.
And these are people with families, man.
Yeah, man. You know, that's what happened to all these people. You know, Cornerstone, Backbone, Mickey Finn, Groove Rider, Fabio. You know, real Cornerstone, Doc Scott, Goldie. Certain people who are foundation in this. Yeah, and I say it loud. Proper foundation. Not even funny out here. Yeah, so I don't want people to try and get it twisted. I think they can, you know, people made a couple of tunes and made a one hit one there and they give it all this. Nah, not having it. Yeah, me, Fiverr, what? Not having it, not at all. So there you have it, yeah? So if you want to question it, challenge it, cool. But hey, I'm still not having it.
Thanks for that, Fiverr, man. That's a big education there, you know what I mean? Whoever's up for doing a mystery tour as well.
Yeah, man, any promoters up for doing an event, mystery tour, undisclosed venue, psh, I'm your man, I'm in.
That's cool, man. Hopefully, you know what I mean? A few promoters might be watching.
I'm sure they may
be. Let's go with that, man.
Yeah, but it would work. I might have put it to the test and see if it doesn't. You know what I mean? What you got to lose?
Yeah, you know.
What you got to lose?
All right, cool, man. Well, we're coming to the end of the interview. I hope you enjoyed yourselves, people.
I've had a good time.
Have you enjoyed
it?
Yeah,
man.
Thanks for coming down.
No, thank you for inviting me. No, man. Yeah, big man. Honestly, fully equipped. It, man. Enough respect. And I'll tell you, as I said, let me just say this. You guys got a fantastic thing going on here in terms of your show. And keep doing what you're doing. I'll tell you this. You got my full support, what you guys are doing. And I think you guys are doing a fantastic thing. Especially young, you know, young guys such as yourself, looking to make the station elevate, and you're making your station and your show elevate, and you're bringing something else a little bit different to the something with essence, something with substance. Not everybody can be a DJ, not everybody can be an MC, not everybody can be a producer, but there are other angles. And I must say, going up to Diamond, Set Up and Get Up, which I'm doing on Wednesday mornings. Don't watch no Fierce Diamond because you know something I love you said we are. Yeah, don't watch nothing. Yeah. So don't forget, Set Up and Get Up. I do that on Cool FM Wednesday mornings. Anything else?
Yeah, last question. We asked this to everyone. What message would you give to the youth of today?
You know what I'd like to say to the youth of today, yeah? Stay alive. Stay loving. Don't get yourself mixed up in something that you can't get yourself out of. Yeah? And life's... is a sure reality. It's not a movie. Yeah, and you know, if you can do your utmost best to stay away from all kind of wrongdoings and any kind of badness. Yeah, I know it's hard for some of you youngsters out there. There's a lot of youngsters out there don't want to be involved in crime. I know there's a lot of youngsters don't want to be in gangs, but I can see sometimes you're not left with much of an alternative, because I could very well remember when we was growing up. Under the Conservative government, let me remind those, yeah?
What are you saying, Maggie Thatcher, yeah?
Man, I'll tell you, it was a tough time. Though, let me tell you something. Never in the UK did they have riots as frequent as they did under the Conservative government, yeah? Now we've got a Lib Dem Con.
Yeah, big up Chef on that one.
Condemn, Dem Con, whatever. And My thing with the situation is that they're gonna, especially with the proposal of the 60 billion cuts, that when that kicks in, that's when I find that you're gonna see a lot of hardship. I think the crime will increase. I think there's gonna be more deprivation. I think it's gonna be a rough time, and I could possibly see riots on the cards in this country.
But you know what? Maybe it might liberate saints.
So you know what I'm saying? I'm about liberation. We've done revolution, and I'm about liberation. You know what I'm saying? So, because right back now, you know, as I said, I'm deep into certain things. You know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, I don't measure myself by materialistic gains and, you know, or materialistic possessions. And I don't measure myself that way. I measure myself by my deeds and how I go about. Performing my deeds and what kind of help I can do for people. So to the youth out there, stay alive and stay loving, man, because love conquers all. You know what I mean? You can run with all that hate, and if your friends are in the Iron Curtain, they're saying, yeah boy, this is the thing to do. No, it's not. Going to the Iron Curtain is not the spot. It is a waste man thing. Honestly, it's not the place. If you're gonna be in that place there, you better do something with that time. You've got plenty of time to do something with it. best to make the most of it. So please don't try not to find yourself there. And all you youngsters out there, you've got to stay loving, stay living, man, stay together. Why are you alienating yourselves against each other and fighting? What do you know what you're fighting against each other for? Half of you youngsters don't even know. Find out what you're doing, yeah? Find that within yourself. So stay loving, stay living, and stay alive, and be more together. I want to see more joy and more togetherness. That's what I want.
Thanks for that, Fiverr. A round of applause, Hitman.
Thank you, too. Thank you, too.
Fully's Facts of the Week, right? Got one, yeah? Last week I started this, right? Fully's Facts of the Week. Winchester was the original capital of England.
Was it?
It was, man.
It was the capital of England. So what happened to, why is it London now, then?
We do it big down here, that's why. Listen, Fibo, if you wouldn't mind, sign the Heavy Artillery t-shirt.
Yeah, man, you mean King? No worries with that,
take
man.
Take your place on there, man.
Yeah, I see Russia's up on here. I see a wild man up there. I see who's up there. Who's up there now? Pasco's up there. Who else is there? Drips up in there. Tommy up there. Okay, who's up there as well? Funky Flirts up there. Torchman's in there. Russia. Who was? The Skibbity, yeah? Shady. All right, Shady's in there now, yeah? All right. Fiverr's going on this big t-shirt as well, yeah? Making all fully equipped. Done, no. Big respect. I mean, fat net. Large.
Right, thank you, Fiverr, for coming down. Enough respect, brother. Old tight Hitman behind the decks right about now. Myself fully equipped. Hope you've enjoyed the show. Heavy Artillery Show every Thursday from 9 to 11. Just remember, stay locked in and you'll see Fiverr do what he does best, all right? So I hope you enjoyed the show. Any feedback, good feedback, bad feedback, it's all good. It's all feedback, man. So big up your chest. I'll tight all the viewers locked in. I'll tight Nigel Mancar. I'll tight all the boys. I'll tight all the Fat Beats crew. Hitman.
Yeah, this happens to be the Shocking, bigging up the Heavy Artillery Massive in the Hizzle. Hey Diddle.
You are now in tune to the sound of DJ Fully Equipped. And DJ.
Coming to do Bumble Class something. The people are out there waiting for the music. Want the Bumble Class to take this thing far. Why as I come on, I must go out with this Bumble Class sabotage. Mercy.
Yeah. Once again, signs of the Fat Net, large every time. All top fully equipped. Not it, man. Fat Beats in the place. Big tune every time. Yeah, once again, Alter LTJ Bookham. Sounds of the It Man. Don't know. We're nice in another place. They better listen to jungle drum and bass. We have sex appeal and we have not good taste. Here, Fat Beats, you better loss up the place. Not we in the is the original Godfather. Yeah, man, I'll tell you. It's you. Why? You know? Tell him! Not a mercy, eh? What? Oh, yeah, better than them. What? Selector, pull up! Pull up! Are you mean, man? You can't better than God, you know? What? No man can't bad like G-O-D, you know? Make you know that. Once again, yeah, man, Fat Net every time. Big inch and every time. Finally enjoy my time. Getting into the hit, man. Yeah, man, you mean each and every time. Fully equipped, large. Every artillery I go on, yes, sir. You mean full equipped. Once again, outside of Russia, making it happen. Next amount of respect, you don't know. Outside of Fox, outside Lady Diamond. You mean set up and get to outside Uncle Dogs. Large every time, outside my brother Uncle Dogs. Connoisseur Mandy family. Ah! Once again, the fat beats. Yeah, we're rolling like this early morning, early evening. What's up, mate?
Waiting
for the music. Why as I come and I must go with this bomboclad sabotage. Yeah, man, keep your dedication and your livercations and your requesting. You know, so this a fat beat. Coming at it and recognize them, your beats. We represent the scene, recognize them, your street. Hear them, your team, what? Said this a hit, man, I'm just now fully equipped. Sounds of the original Top Cat, listen good. Lot of mercy, eh? You're also the original Conga Natty, aka Rebel MC. Don't know a large. But I watch them, what? Don't know about them. End up in a L. Way, what?
As it was in the
beginning. How shall it be in the end?
I'm gonna take people life. It's a big sacrifice. Cause a dead your soul is gone.
Once again, fully equipped. Hitman in the place. Listen to them, your sound. You're not so far. Busy, we are the best pound for pound. Now can't talk to we. We are the real veteran. Hear them, your man. We still your historian.
We are God bless your son.
So that's it, I won't.
I'm gonna
fry y'all. Better than them. What? Once again, hit us up with your emails. So we're loving it. To all my jungle, it's 5X. 5X. Better than them. And we're end up in that L. Yeah. Yeah, I got a Cheyenne. Each and every time, yeah, I'm in the Romford region. Locked on. Yeah, say happy birthday, guys, to the Inman. Fully artillery, fully equipped, you don't know. Heavy artillery show. Better than them. Once again, signs of your fully equipped heavy artillery. Heavy artillery in the place. Yes, selector. Yo, I'll touch Trevor Seven Oaks, you don't know. XMR to respect, bless him. Yeah, touch over 7 Oaks, everything good. Once again, heavy artillery, fully equipped, hitman in the place. Many thanks once again for those who's locked on. Don't enjoy my time. Listen them your sound, hear them your mix, the hitman flinging down. No flick down for fat beat selection. Put in a dip, it's a godfather, pad down microphone. Listen them your one, we are second to none. Our stars are identical to none. one of the kind, one in a million. Once again, if you like, hit us up with your emails. Sound of the Hitman.
Yeah.
Once again, Heavy Artillery Show, you don't know. Fire the beer shots. Out of Slumsy. But in comes the Teddy Riley. The Teddy Riley alongside the Black Street. Here it man, drop it on the fat beats. Here then there's some nice, you know, up the scene. We are back when we keep the people them keen. Keep it nice, we don't it and we don't feel. What? We don't dirty and you know, we stay clean.
No dickity. No gap.
Still moving this flavor
with the sound of the Black Street.
Teddy, the original.
Yes, Hitman. Once again, get to our jungle, it's 5X, 5LX. Just down. Once again, to off jungle, it's 5X. Every day. Yes, selector. Out of Sunsy. What's up, sister? What's good? The west side.
It's no surprise. She got tricks in the stash. Stacking up the. When it comes to the gas, by no means average.
Yo, to the Sunsy, nuts. Once again, fat beats.
Can I get down? So
Sunsy, the equipped.
I like the way you work, kid.
Alongside the Hitman, no fully diggity, artillery.
No dickity. I got to bag it, bag
it. Yeah, man, so we come to bag it.
No down.
Oh, you want to reload, yeah? Work it. Teddy Riley, Black Street.
Bag it.
So yeah, this a Hitman with the fully equipped alongside Mr. Five of the full artillery. They better get to know, they better listen to we. Your ear far, basically comfy nice on the street. So this is the Black Street alongside Teddy Riley. Listen them, you think we keep people lively. We keep them nice, we keep the people jiggy. We keep them well jiggy like the one Jay-Z. Yeah, them, you take that heavy artillery. With the five of Mr. Hitman, Godfather MC. They can't talk to where we are the truth and daddy. Better hear them, you think we the celebrity. Better come and listen them, you one. You're not some artillery, go with the heavy ammunition. Hear them, you think you're not so we of the plan. Get with this thing called with the program. Now better get with this one. Better get with the link up, get with the program. You're not so heavy artillery of the ammunition. So who in the place to fully equip and eat, man? Yeah, man, so we come to roll it at this night here. Fatbeats.net. So we come to roll out, let me mix. Once again, get your emails in. Yeah, them your one. Coming out the place, you're not so we have the plan. We represent the L-O-N-D-O-N. London. There is only one done. Going at the place original London. You better get to know you're not so we have the plan. It's a way back when.
No diggity, diggity.
So once again, as I say, welcome to Fat Beats, Hitman. Lots are fully equipped. Heavy Artillery. Let's know this. See me now, yeah? I'll see you too. Cool, yeah? Rolling out with a jungle drum and bass. Fat Beats. Once again, as we roll it like this with a Fat Beast for the 11 o'clock hour. As you know, it's the fatbeats.net. So roll like this. Sounds of the Artillery. Hitman, the fully equipped. So once again, sound of heavy artillery, union, fat beats, jungle drum and bass. Remember, bank holiday this weekend. Take your time. Yes, fully equipped. You know we're coming fully, we're coming fully equipped. When you listen then you sing along like it man in a this. We represent the full artillery, young mimix. Hear them you think what? We're going for lock it proper. Yes, sounds of the fully equipped once again. Alongside the hitman tonight, full artillery. Well, see you around, technical issues here. Yo, yada yo, say yada yo. It's a name of music, no, so we not come for yo. It man, our lungs are full artillery, fun to blow. So it man, in the place. You remember fatbeats.net. Once again, sound of the Fat Beats. Do not forget tonight, we are legend. Devious Rude MC Ribs. Don't forget tonight, we're in a Commercial Road area, East London side. Wake up and run out them, yeah, son. Wake up and run them, yeah, mix. So, who in the best of all artillery? So, hear them, yeah, son, original. Then you're a full artillery. Listen, them, yeah, man, they come and let off the rocket launcher. Hear them, yeah, tickling the clock and with the SLR. The full artillery, they come and load it, papa. Now load it, papa, come load the entertainer. You hear that full artillery, them big bout, yeah. You hear that kind of music, now we run for cover. Yeah, man, we some big spunders again, yeah. They better run for cover, they better run for cover. To a sambata, to a perpetrator. You're not so far, please, you know them big bout, yeah. Survive along, I hit my artillery done, yeah, yeah. Full, we with the fully equipped. We're coming at the things, we come with things, we're legit. You better get to know, we do not keep up no shit. Hear them, yeah, son, I want you, hear them, yeah, mix. Taking man in the place, mixing up the turntable techniques. Hear them, yeah, son, I want you, hear the kind of lick. You talk to with your original jungleist. What? You better hear them, yeah, son, I better hear the kind of mix. We call it Fat Beats, Father Mesa, Fat Beats, pull up! Fat Beats, Father Mesa, Fat Beats, pull up! Amen. Now tell them. We call it Fat Beats, Father Mesa, Fat Beats, pull up! Fat Beats, Father Mesa, Fat Beats, pull up! That is an it, man, alongside the equip. Two of them together, now say they're well legit. Don't even try, to take the piece. Any boy, think you with a fucking cup of fish. You get a big clap and then you will get toughest. You ever try, even try for confidence. The full artillery, we have your ammunition, Chris. hear them your sound. What? Full artillery. You know that these guys are loaded with the weapons. Oh my life! Come back and rock, come back and sway. Yeah, my selector on, yeah, the DJ. What? Come back and rock, come back and sway. Yes, Hitman, when I tell them. Yeah, I'll tell MC Shabba. Anyway, now, I mean, selector, I'm gonna pull up them fat beats till you don't know. Fat beats, but I miss a fat beats. Pull up! Straight like that. And that's how we're rolling this night. Can you see me? I can see you. What class? Oh, they're working. Can you see me? I can see you. Oh, Junglets, I love you, you know that. All Junglets, 5X, 5X. Over the age of consent, though. Anything over the age of consent can't deal with me, yeah? Nothing over the, yeah, nothing under the age of consent you can't deal with me. Sons of Hitman, fully equipped. Then I said them on the target. Then I wake up and launch it. Yo, what's up, Flinty Badman, Demon Rocker, all the RTC family. All the time is a Koji. Yeah, we got the basement. All the time Spider. All the time MC Trigger. Being on the side, keep the moves. All the time GQ, Fearless. Singing Fats. Yeah, all the time X-Man, Skibber. Major Yardy, all the time Cowboy Ranger. Yeah, all the time Sweet P, one, one. What's good? Hitman fully equipped. Rock up winner, skin and winner, jump up in at this. Yeah, then the real judge on my bass jungleist. Bossy better now, you can come take the piece. You try to do that, you get a cut from with this. Yeah, then there's some with the fully equipped. The heavy artillery with the 1-8 man. That's a damn man, original champion. We are back when you're not, sir. They better run for cover, they better run for cover. So all sound battles are a perpetrator. They can't come on the edge of junglist corner. Put in on the base of junglist defender. So teacher with a lecture and judge a messenger. When you hear them, your son, I want hear them flavor. We not deal with the devil, Satan or Lucifer. We blaze up the fire and we Chris Johnson, yeah. Yeah. Once again, Runaway Style, fatbeats.net. Yeah, all that Mustafa, you don't know, sister. All that Jane, all that Shaquilla, Aisha, all that baby Evelyn. Fuck! Yeah, I said, we got the fat beast. I said, yeah, man, I mean, large at the 5-1. I mean, it's a season better, man. We are back when, right till now, you don't know. Heavy artillery. 21st century. That's a damn, man, the heavy artillery. Can't talk to where we are, the long son daddy. Yeah, damn, that's how we have too much history. Once again to all my junglets, 5X. Once again to all the females. We said that woman with a shan winner, Laura Shan man. Hold a woman winner, hold a man, we said that. We know you're watching, you don't want to say nothing. It's cool though. Well, you don't want to give me no props. That's alright, that's cool. Yeah, I'll talk MC Foxy, you don't know. Oh, DJ Fox. Yeah, I'll talk DJ Fox. What's going on, King? So what's good, Fox? Each and every time. I'll talk the Russian, the Fox, the region, White Warriors. Yeah, man, that's what I can't live in now. They'll know this. No, I won't get charged by the Racial Commission. You're right. CRE's all right with me with that. The Russian, the Fox, innit? Why is it I'll talk the Ross stuff? Yeah, being a fat man D, I was at MC Funster. So once again, Sands and Heavy Artillery, Fat Beats. Yeah, make sure you do lock onto these guys' shows. These guys are running a fantastic campaign. Lead that. These guys are doing a good thing here. Guys, that's all the rest of the fraternity. If these guys come and ask you for an interview and you turn them down, fire. Yeah? I'm putting a fire on all of you. So don't forget, each and every Thursday, the Heavy Artillery Show, fully equipped alongside the Hitman. So each and every Thursday, right here, fatbeats.net. Also catch me 5-0 each and every Wednesday morning, set up and get up with my co-presenter Diamond. Whoa! Yes, fully equipped, fully equipped. Serena, you're my selector, we call it one fully equipped. When we come in the place, you know we come to get a grip. Here, there, you think you know we top of the tip. Here, there, you so we make dance all them up hip. Them better listen, them young dicks. Hitman in the place, and with the fully equipped. The two are get together, every artillery. Here, there, you so jungle, drum and bass, yes, yes, you see. Yes, in comes.
I don't understand.
What? Now here comes. Yeah, man, some jungle drum and bass pressure. What? Now here comes. The better listen to me a track. We come a nice song, the city neighborhood and block. Phenomenon, phenomenon. Listen for this next station. Phenomenon, phenomenon. Fatbeats.net station. Heavy artillery, them a big gang. I lost a miss, I hit my fully equipped man. All of we together, now so we are one gang. We call it fully equipped. When it comes to this, we keep things a little legit. We keep them legit, just like the 11 digits. Hear them, your son, I want to hear them, your miss. Pioneer, a guardian angel, jungle drum and bass, and I say, one and for all, hear them, you're singing, I say.
This is what you've been waiting for.
Listen to this one, good, the better, listen, papa. Guardian angel and pioneer, hear them, you're singing, expensive and dear. You know we shock, like Shaka Zulu spear. They better get to know, they better beware. We don't care. You better call up the cops. So when it comes to this, the fatbeats.net coming at the blazing now with live and direct. Live and direct, if you can't come reject. Hear them, your music, you can't come intercept. You're rocking on your movie, fatbeats.net. Once again, fully equipped the Hitman in the place. We call it Hitman, a lance are fully equipped. And this is fatbeats.net in the mix. Here then you dance our music, make you sick. When you make you feel jolly, I'll make you sick. In our dip is the fatbeats.net. Live and direct, you know we have intercept. Here then your music, say we're live and direct. Yeah man, coming out good. Coming out good, yeah, now we're coming out strong. Fatbeats.net combination. Alongside the club for the coffee, touch it down. Better in our center is the competition. The three are we together in a good condition. Oh my, my, I want to them. Yeah man, I want to them. I wanna them, I wanna them, them. They got me not the all. We not the all. I mean, reggae matic style. Reggae matic sound, we call reggae matic style. Putting out them if we come to drive them wild. Reggae matic sound, reggae matic style. Putting out them place with the cool profile. That internet don't hear them, you want. Yeah! Yeah man, I want to them. Jungle jungle bass that we defend 2010. And we don't end. Sounds of the Eco Mouse. Yeah, the sound of the original Eco Mouse. I mean, it's the original Monday. Son of the Prophet, Fireman. They said, I wanna them. Yeah, fuck these dots, let me come again. Yeah. I wanna them. Fuck these dots, let me hear we again.
I miss it. Me rock a muffin, I'm international.
What?
To kill a DJ, me do a partial.
Cutty Ranks.
I ain't got the credentials.
I ain't got the Cutty Ranks. Dark of it, Papa. So the Cutty Ranks. Once again, sound of the fatbeast.net. Heavy Artillery Show. Each and every Thursday. Check out the guys, Hitman and Fully Equipped. Call a boom, original run the country. Put in a the place and we don't talk to anybody. It's a boom, original run the country. They show that where they call every artillery. So fuck these dot network of community. So put in a the place and better listen to it. So Godfather, the one hit man. The one fully equipped, you know, so we come for jump. Jump down on the active artillery station. Once again, as we do it like this, right throughout the community, global world. Those down on the net, hit us up, send your emails across. Sounds of the fatbeat.net. Each and every Thursday, check these guys out. For those who missed the interview, I'm sure it's down on the podcast. So be on the YouTube. Oh, well, that's a good thing, isn't it? Yeah, I was at a sick note. Yeah, I was at the Hastings family. Yeah, I still love the Hastings pair. Yeah, going to gym. Original Heat. Yeah, for those who visit the pair. Down the Hastings region. Sounds of the Fully Equipped. And you need to come fully equipped when you come out. You need one of these. But show that. Boom! Boom! They say, we're love with Cess. Yes, we love with. No, Cess Fabregas, though. He's gone. We love with.
Yes, we love with Cess. Come follow it. We love with Cess. I'm gonna say, yes, we love with.
We don't want no ashes like this, son. We don't want no ashes, son. What? Big business, son. From rods to riches, son.
Big time,
touch up on
them.
Big time, Chris, son.
She
and them,
they can't
go to the straight like that, Mr. It Man in another place, fully equipped, we don't know. So we come to set it straight on the fatbeast.net. Yeah, so if you've got any more texts or emails, would appreciate it because you know I love to read and really makes good for my vocabulary. So if you have any emails that you need to email us up, then hit us up.
Big up Rebel MC and all of the jungle scroll.
And then Congo Nati have done a large blessed love.
Metal people, do you love sense? Oh Lord, we fire love sense, me la come tell me.
You have a serious big choose up here now. Metal
them,
we love with
says. Yes, we love with says, come follow it. We love with says, I'm gonna say yes, we love it. We love with says, yes, we love with says, come follow it. We love with says, I'm gonna say yes, we love it.
We got the vibes like this, son. We don't want the ashes, son. You want to wear dapper, you don't know, large. Big business, son.
just a register. Big time clutch up, but them have a just press. She and all them, they can't go just for the rest. Five stop up in a shine pan, edge face. Not a dry push, not a dry process. After both them and cut them, I do a service. Each and every one, I want your respect.
It's a bun sense of mania. Make your body stronger. Don't make you older. The first the paper. And big all over. Time entertainer. The truth I remember. Was the brigadier the teacher? Was the one Michael Palmer? With the one sense of media. Police in a helicopter. Dump out my ganja. Herb and ganja. And now we the worst shit. We are the danger. Yes, what's up MC Hooligan? You don't know, one, one. What's good Hooligan, what's good? You're out of juice man. Don't know, big. Yes, we love it. Yeah, also MC Hooligan, you don't know. Yes, boss.
Yes, boss.
Original John on things. I want to search for. I want to look for. What am I search for? That's how they can't come find a door of ganja. What they searching for? Them just a look for search, yes, for man. Wait, what? Nah. So once again, fatbeast.net growing like this. Sounds of Hitman, lots are fully equipped. The Heavy Artillery Show, each and every Thursday, right here on your fatbeast.net. As you know, these gentlemen will be interviewing a great deal of celebrities throughout the scene. So stay and give the man some love, yeah? So don't forget, if you're around in the East London region and you are looking for somewhere to go this evening, we are Legend, which takes place at the Gramophone. And that's at 60 to 62 Commercial Street in Spitalfields E1. There's a full address here, yeah? So, that's where it's at tonight, yeah? Yeah, watch the auto SC Hooligan in Dunno. Once again, sound of the Fat Beast up next. Yeah man, keep it like this, fatbeast.net. Rubber-dub style. Once again, Ultra Hooligan, Ultra Juice Man, A Sound Boy.
Work.
You want top Bobby, don't know. All's the massive Northwest crew. Don't know, Bridgeport massive. Blessed love.
It's the remix, baby.
So all time original Northwest massive, Stonebridge massive, Chalk Hill, Church Avenue, don't know, large on Northwest massive. Long Kong. And a bunch of roads, and I started to run. Yeah, I'll touch Trevor Seven Oaks, team set up and get up. I'll type deals. Big up Money Penny. I'll type Daniel Lisa Chesson. Yeah, great, my co assistant presenter. Sister Diamond. Get my set up and get up, you know. The road was to come. Sounds like Baron to Levy. Set up the stairs and come. And if you don't come quick, you're not gonna if you can get up the stairs. If you can get up them stairs, bloody hell. Do you know how much she weighs? Bloody hell. It takes you about 2 months to get up them stairs. That's why she has to wait later. I'm broad, we're broader than Broadway, whoa! Once again, fatbeast.net. Each and every Thursday, right here. Willie, whoa! Oh, it's that Cabby. World one. I'm broader than. No, we're broad. I've had a fantastic evening, I must say. Boy, man, just slowed that one right down there. DJ. What? Where you get it from? I said that it, man. Now where you get it from? Where you find them wicked nice selection? We said that where we get it from? From the fatbeast.net, good condition. Better not a 2010, is that you just legend? Hear them, your music, that's your way, and we jump. We better hear them, your one. It, man, alongside, yes, the fully equipped heavy artillery. We come distribute this. Your drum and bass junglist. Yeah, here we're live and we're Chris. Personal favorite, this one here. Way back when, out at DJ Randall to out to Andal. We call it something I feel. That's what it's about. Music is a love, it's a feel, it's a vibe, isn't it? Yes, family, yeah. I'm on that one there, Trev. Yeah, I'm on that, fam.
Might check 1, 2. Yo, management, if you could give either me or Hitman a quick call. Thanks.
Yes, yes.
Yes, I go out to management. Can you kindly get in touch with Fully Equipped or the Hitman? So it goes out to the staff of personal management. Can you kindly get in touch? Yeah, I'll take Jay
I mean over in the Hackney region, I mean Pomer Ends. Well, you rock it up.
Yes,
we're
going to
mash it up, come nice it up, come pull up. Then we be at them, you think we come, we're fully equipped. The hitman in the place, it come fit, launch this mix. It come and launch it like a missile rocket.
Yes, yes.
Isn't them your son, you better can't risk this. You can't risk this, I know you can't take the piss. Can't take the piss of drama bass jungleist. A boy come fit, yes, they get clapped, boxed with fists. Anytime test, better listen them your mix. You know, so them your man is, and we don't miss. Fuck beast, don't make you better hear this. Oh my god! Oh my my! Yes, my name is Serious Tune this. See the tune, you know? That's all I'm saying, I'm a song. No, we don't tune that. We don't tune that. The reason I got to pull up this tune in particular, you should have asked me this in an interview. This particular tune, yeah, I actually went to do the video in Jamaica myself. Yeah, me, Rebel MC, Jumping Jack Frost, and DJ Run. And I hold this tune in particular very close to my heart because, as I said, we did a video shoot. And the video shoot was one of the most craziest times I've had it in my life in actually doing a video shoot ever. But at the present time, I don't know if you're aware of what's going on in Jamaica at the moment with... There's a lot of madness going on over there looking for this guy, Dudas. He's known as the Robin Hood of today, but the Americans will have you believe he's something else. But when can you ever believe the Americans anyway? They went to war illegally, so can you believe that? So we're not going to get into that, but the shoot here, I'm going to livercate for those right now in Kingston, Jamaica, whether you're from Matches Lane, Wildtown Park, Cockburn Pen, Tivoli Gardens, Tel Aviv, Garrison, Gaza, wherever you're from, this is going out to you, because right back now, it's crazy going on down there at the moment, and boy, I'm happy to be in England right now. So, anyone who's got any families in Jamaica at this present time, this is for you. Anyway, selector, run reading trap. Especially those in Spanish town, Kingston.
Our junglers.
Yeah, man, Manchester, the one place over there, sir. Our junglers.
Our junglers.
What I'm saying, man? Our junglers. I was at DJ Easy, Aylesbury. And I'll tell you, I'm gonna beppy. Hands on of a song. Hands on of a song. Pocket to the gear, the figure. Pocket to the gear, the figure. You also nice your mind part every chill every time. And I say, yeah, my love up every time.
Hey, 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 hey,
hey. Cool up, Beppy, over in the Indus region. Super cap, listen, bad India.
Dime a dime. Matica, matica, nine a nine. Romantica, so much up on my spine every time. 16 or something, carry over show lights and every time. The youth in my car, oversized clip on combine. Watch me now.
Hit me now, they get us on it. They run the 1-1 and then they pop your waistline. You could have fire carbine. It's you, what I tell you. Right now, those are Tivoli Gardens right now. And I'm talking to ooh. Yeah, also the Bam and the Massive, also the Combs. Turn on my radio, Raga. Tell them my radio, Raga. And I'll tell you, Kuna Wassa. And then no long cry, man. And if you come and cry, man, panda. Radication, man, come in and then pop your waistline. You're gonna fire combine. And I'll tell you, don't end up talking to you. Listen good. So it's you. Once again, get to the management, staff, personnel. If you'd like to get in touch with Fully Equipped or the Hitman ASAP, you all touch Trevor 7 of sit down the large, big. I mean, large at the inside, straight gully, this is done the bummer. Done the straight gully thing.
Send it down. And then it, you're padding. Radication. You're going up by your 16. We see you, when I tell you. Yes, Hitman. Large every time. Lots of the fully equipped. I am talking. Yeah, man, what's up, man? A Reggie Stepper. So once again, as we say, welcome. As we draw to a very near end. Many, many thanks again to the Heavy Artillery Show. Fully equipped. Hitman, for allowing me to be here with a fatbeast.net station. Thoroughly enjoyed my time. Once again, the Hitman, a lot of full artillery. The quick smashing at the cheese. Believe that. Showing their skills. Definitely showing their skills, you gentlemen. What's that? The whistle he done, no, other than Eno, so yeah, my shit, golly. I have a corner funk. Yeah, I'll take a funk in the Basingstoke region. I'll take the Dizzy over the Elvesbury. Wagga. Oh, he's on the colour nose. Once again, that was the emailing. Totally had a good time with you guys. I've had a great time tonight. What? You're out of the Birmingham Ice then. Yo, to my brother, I sit down the large. There's an old HMP Iron Curtain. Then better not say, better not say, them are done. Better not say, them are done. Then come back, we are back long. Come out of sound system, I'm up here, me man. Who in there, please, better. Now better sit up, listen, listen up, pay attention. You better get to know the cover, set down the plan. Oh, I set it up, America and England. Alongside your European Union. You better get to know the United Nation. Biometrics, yes, for each and everyone. So far you in your chop. Hey, you know. Microchips in your forehead and your right hand. Better get to know, yes, for each and everyone. Yeah, the Matrix coming on. Once again, every birthday again to DJ Hitman every time. It's a birthday celebration, get to DJ Hitman each and every time. Once again, as we move into the last one. Yeah, don't forget the big rewind, 2nd of July. Don't forget. And the 2nd of July rewinding back to Jungle Divas D. Myself, Rocket, MC Det, Rough Stuff, MC Fun. Yeah, I was at the Lizard, the Viper, Future Thinking. Man, that's gonna be serious. So don't forget, over in Chester, 2nd of July. Yeah, you got the original Rocky MC Det. Lots of the Divas, Reboy D. And lots of DJ Ross, the MC Fun. Lizzie and DJ Viper alongside myself. Yeah. We come from blaze the fire. But not the thing, we come from blaze the fire. Cool as Chevy 7-Ox. We come in and the place, we come from blaze up the fire. But me not let them come in entertainer. You better not step up me down in entertainer. You better hear us when you come to inquire. Better not a jungle drummer, bass your supplier. Hear them, you think we take the people higher. Today we get 2nd of July. Yeah, we're gonna be making our way up to Chester, up north. Right, may I just say this again to the fatbeats.net.co, right? Excuse me. Fatbeats.net, but going to management and staff and personnel, and also to these two young gentlemen here. Thank you so much for inviting me and allowing me to be here amongst you guys. I thoroughly enjoyed my time. I do love the scene, yeah. Some people might say I wear too much on my sleeve, but hey. That's how it goes, isn't it? I love the scene. So, if you're thinking about doing anything at this coming bank holiday weekend, wherever you're doing, be safe doing what you're doing. So tonight we're going to be making our way out to We Are Legend down at Commercial Road at the Gramophone. So if you're in the East London area and you're doing anything, I don't know what's going on this coming weekend, come bank holiday, because I don't think I'm doing anything. But 2nd of July, don't forget, we're going to be making our way to Chester. DJ Brucky, Devious, D, myself, Viper, Rasta, MC5. So we're going to be up north in Chester region at 2nd of July, which I'm quite looking forward. It's Hitman, fully equipped, full artillery. Thank you so much for today. And I'm sure I may be back forward sometime later in the year. You never know. It might be might be Christmas. I'm a Christmas drink here, you know what I mean? So fatbeats.net, thank you again, yeah? Absolutely, man, thank you so much. Thank you so much, you guys. I really appreciate my time. So, last one of these guys. Do check these guys out each and every Thursday. These guys are doing a fantastic thing. Look out for these guys. Support these guys as well. They're doing a fantastic. There you go. Look, it's been live recorded. Facebook. What else? Facebook. YouTube. My God, we slept across the place. There's no hiding for no one no more. Hey, who cares? So anyway, last song for the fatbeats.net tonight and this heavy artillery show. And also, as I said, DJ Hitman are fully equipped with their last one. Thank you so much to all the listeners, those who's locked in, and those who's emailing. Thank you so much, we had a great time. Selector, run with him.
Now big up all the jungle river, them another place. I like to crow. I'll jump up massive. For real. This is not a bar,
yeah, so we come to do it, fatbeats.net.
We
have a fantastic evening.
Fire!
Oh my, my, demolition! Fire! Yeah, I mean, once again, original fire. Going out to the one like Demolition Man in Dunwall. Old Tat Sid Young.
No big up all the jungle river never place. I like to crow, I'll jump up massive.
For real.
This is not a bargain or a deal. Listen to the words of the first song. More time out here and young puppet in the place. Down with my lyrical tongue. I'll go to them. What's this? Fire. Only if it burn the place down. Demolition deaf and they mic and the wise known as Neil Young.
Fire.
Who know if they cut your lights up or right down. May have something for telling the people in your case. Not even if it might sound more time out.
We are the rough next slow talk. We are the rough next slow talk. The better not say fatbeats.net. The better get to know we low and direct. We got a rough day skeleton. We got a rough neck. Guy, guy, guy.
Listen to the music I play. At the same time right on me I pick up me DJ. Take a ding
Yeah, it always comes about. It's always someone hating. But it's the haters that make us do this. Don't you know that? It's the haters that make us do this. Yeah, I'll tell Marky Mark, I don't know.